Ladies and gentlemen, Gary and Kim welcome you here today to Len Wade House on the happy occasion of their marriage. I'm sure it means a great deal to them that you are here today to share in their happiness and celebrate with them the beginning of their married life together. My name is Hilary Patterson, and it's my pleasure and privilege to be conducting the ceremony here today on behalf of Norfolk Registration Service. I would now like to introduce my colleagues. This is Zilla Fuller, and Zilla will be registering the marriage today and ensuring that all the legal formalities are completed correctly. And this is Nikki Painter. This place in which we are now met has been duly sanctioned according to law for the celebration of marriages. The ceremony will be in accordance with the law of this country, which requires the couple to declare their freedom to marry each other before they make their marriage contract and promise to take each other as partners for life. So you are all here today to witness the marriage of Gary David Johnson and Kimberly Elizabeth Turney. If any person here present knows of any legal impediment to this marriage, it must be declared now.
Thanks.
It has long been tradition for a bride to be given away. And today that honour falls to the bride's father, Mick, and the bride's grandfather, George. So, Mick and George, will you entrust Kim to the love and care of Gary?
We will.
Very much. I'd like to take your seats, gentlemen. Thank you. Gary and Kim, before you are joined in marriage, I should remind you both of the solemn and binding nature of the vows that you are about to make. Marriage is a promise of hope between two people who love each other, to share love and friendship, and to offer help and comfort in times of joy and in times of sorrow. So Gary and Kim will now declare that there is no legal reason why they should not marry before they go on to complete their marriage contract. So I'm going to ask each of you a question now, and your response to this is, I am, okay. So Gary, traditionally, gentleman goes first. So are you, Gary David Johnson, free lawfully to marry Kimberly Elizabeth Turney?
I am.
Are you, Kimberly Elizabeth Turney, free lawfully to marry Gary David Johnson?
I am.
Thank you. Right. We now have your contracting words. So if you want to turn and face each other, do you want to take each other's hands? Okay.
Thanks.
And we're speaking to each other now. Right. So Gary, you're going to repeat this after me.
Right.
I, Gary David Johnson.
I, Gary David
Take you, Kimberly Elizabeth Turney.
Take you, Kimberly Elizabeth Turney.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
Thank you. I, Kimberly Elizabeth Turney.
I, Kimberly Elizabeth Turney.
Take you, Gary David Johnson.
Take you, Gary David Johnson.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
Now, I'm going to ask you each another. Question now to ask both of you. This time the response is I do. Okay? So, Gary, do you take Kimberly to be your wife? And do you promise to be loving, caring, and loyal to her for the rest of your life together? Kimberly, do you take Gary to be your husband? And do you promise to be loving, caring, and loyal to him for the rest of your life together?
I do.
Gary and Kim have chosen to demonstrate their commitment this afternoon by the giving and the receiving of rings. A wedding ring is a symbol of the everlasting circle of love, truth, and unity in which two lives are joined together. So now we need the rings. Remind you both of the promises that you have made to each other today. So marriage will be the start of a new beginning, a new phase in your life together. Your marriage calls for cooperation, friendship, and mutual respect. It also needs understanding, patience, honesty, and of course a sense of humour. It requires devotion, the ability to listen, the wisdom to know when you are wrong, and,
sorry.
And the willingness and strength to put things right. Today will be a milestone in your lives, which you can look back on with happiness and pride. From this day, may the ordinary things you share become special, and the special things great. Cherish your love for each other, enhance the potential you have as individuals and as a couple, and look to the future with a commitment that grows deeper and stronger as the years pass. Gary and Kim, you have both made the declarations that are prescribed by law and formed a solemn and binding contract with each other in the presence of your guests here today. You have sealed that contract with the giving and receiving of rings, and you have made promises to each other of love, loyalty, and commitment. I'm delighted to declare that you are now husband and wife.
Congratulations.
Suit you, Gary.
Ladies and gentlemen, if I could just ask you to remain in your seats, please, while we have the signing of the register. Thank you.
There's going to be more of that.
That's what this is.
It has been
Ladies and gentlemen, if you would like to come forward and take some pictures yourselves, please feel free now.
She's having
thanks.
On behalf of Hilary and myself, we'd like to wish you a very long and happy future together, and we hope the rest of your day goes really well for you. Many congratulations.
Ladies and and gentlemen, can I ask you all please to stand? And my last duty of the day is to introduce to you the new Mr. and Mrs. Johnson. Congratulations.
Thank you. Before we start speeches, if I can just ask, before the evening guests come, there's a picture frame there that the bride and groom would like to be signed by all you guys. If everyone would like to go up there and sign, that'd be great. All right, so we are going to start off the speeches, and Sally's going to start us off. So I'll pass you over to Sally.
Thank you. Thank you all for coming and congratulations to, Gary. As you all know, as there are some special people sitting here today. We lost Kim's granddad, my father-in-law, and then at the beginning of the year, it devastated, but we lost my mum. So Kim and I would just like to light a candle because we know they're all with us today. But you've all seen me blubbering, you know why, and well, this is for those that aren't with us today. Yeah, you liked it. Now I'm going to my son-in-law.
Thanks.
Your turn.
Right, hold on,
yeah, can you film this?
How's it going?
I'll rip down on an envelope there. Before I read this, I just want to say thank you to Duffins and Azar, who scored Coventry's goal today, and I won the winners. I'd just like to say thank you all for coming. I know some of you travelled quite far to be here, and me and Kim are really grateful for that. Everyone else turned up. I'd like to thank the bridesmaids for being there for Kim and helping support her, and Angie for helping to do everything as well. It was really nice of you. And I'd like to thank my best men, but if they weren't here today, I'd have to thank these three instead. Yeah. Thanks for that. Hang on, bear with me, I'll swear around.
Take your time, guys.
It's took me and Kim a long time to get where we are. But all of her family have made this all possible. We're trusting me with her. And putting the roof over my head when I was when I was in Cramer. And it's cold and they're beating me.
You wouldn't have lived in that flat, come on.
And I'd like to say thank you to my family as well for always being there, but especially to Kev. So I know I always haven't been the easiest person to get on with over the years, but he's always been there, so thanks for that.
Are you alright? Are you
imagining
where you are?
No. But, here we go. Finally, I'd like to say
thank you to the wife.
She's always been there for me. Are you
alright? Are you wearing that? It's a blue one, a white one.
No, it's always been there. And I couldn't wish this day to be with anyone else but me. I think that's a stage turner.
Oh my god, look at the size of his neck!
So good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Firstly, on behalf of the bridesmaids, I'd like to thank Gaz for his kind words. I think everyone will agree that the bridesmaids look beautiful and did a brilliant job. I'm sure Kimmy went against her better judgment and showed up. I'd also like to thank Chris for his role as best man. You did a great job today. For those who don't know me, I'm Dave. I've known Gaz since junior school. And I've joined best man with the other two.
And you used to bully him.
Honestly, shush.
Wake her. I love you though.
Oh my gosh,
divorce. Before I start the customary character assassination of the groom, I think we can all agree that Kim looks absolutely stunning today. Gaz, I think you've done extremely well, and you found someone who's beautiful, clever, charming, funny, loving, caring. Kim, well, you got here. Who said marriage is a partnership of equals? Finally, can I thank you all for coming here today to share this very special occasion. It's amazing how far people come for a free meal. I did ask for a microphone today, but I was told that there wasn't one available. So if you can't hear me in the back, the silence from the people in front, you should assume you're not missing much. Okay, so one thing. One thing I will say about Kim is she's actually a very good sense of humour, as she's proven today by marrying Gaz. I feel that I've done my duty well so far today, all things considered, delivered the sober groom to the church on time. Well, on time, don't know about sober. And I give you a speech, I don't think I'm going to offend or embarrass anyone, but to ensure that this is my last part, I better keep things fairly short, as I know that Gaz is itching to get to the bar. I was advised not to make the speech too long, which is fine by me. In fact, I was told that best man's speech shouldn't last any longer than it's likely to take the groom to perform his husband's duties on the wedding night. Which is better news, so ladies and gentlemen, please raise your glasses. Bride and groom.
Cheers.
I'm not finished yet.
We've got time to get another drink.
Nah, not much longer. I don't know what Gaz was like before junior school, but I imagine he was a good little boy who didn't get into any trouble.
Yeah.
All right, maybe I've been in the truth a little. Not that far.
Good smell.
Yeah, good little boy. Gaz started off as my school bully. Yeah, but soon got bored of that and became friends, which I'm sure he regrets even more each day. Over the years, we've got into a variety of questionable events, with birdhouses appearing in parents' gardens. Honestly, just wasn't stolen, just appeared. To going clubbing to try and pull, which always ended up with an empty wallet, still sober, and after way too many drinks, no lady to show for it. Well, that's unless you count Gaz's tried and tested technique of writing his number on a napkin and giving it to the women just as we leave.
Thanks for my drink. Thank you. Thank you.
Well, Gaz has had many cars over the years, and will be having many more seven-seaters in the future. He always have a special little stalker right here waiting for him in terms of Kim. It's true that Gaz and Kim first met at the wedding show, me and Sam, and Kim planned this special day ever since then. We all know they would get together, and my bets on behalf of, well, my bet is that by the end of this year, early next year, they'll be announcing some other special news. Before I toast to the happy couple and get a well end drink, let me just say, despite the magnificent way that I'm delivering the speech, I'm not professional. I did it for nothing. I'm sure you'll agree it's worth every penny. On a more serious note, Gaz, we've had some excellent times together. I know we'll continue to do so in the future. You've been a great friend for me over the years, and it's been a great honour to be your best man today. I would like to say best of luck to you two. I'm really delightful for both of you. I hope you have a very long, happy life together. Ladies and gentlemen, it's been an emotional day, even the cake has tears.
Yeah.
Now it gives me an immense pleasure, not to mention relief, to invite you all to stand raised glass to the new Mr. and Mrs. Johnson. Kim and Gaz.
Cheers.
Well done.
I'm not a speech maker, though. I don't need a children's speech. We've had Gaz living with us now for a few years, and it's been really good because we've been out of watch the football. I've been sorry to see him go. This will be his second time because they moved away 2 weeks ago. But the time they've been with us, they've really gone to town on the saving and trying to get a life for themselves, which they have done. And I'll miss Kimmy as well. She's a good worker as well. They're both hard workers. And we love you both, me and the wife. So, and the dogs.
Love the
dogs. Can't forget the dogs. And as you see in the photo, the milky dogs.
One's
a blue, one's a black and white. Anyway, I'd just like to thank you for coming and wish them all the best. And I think they'll do well in life. So, just to you, all the best. Thank you. Thank you.
Kim and Gary just got a few thank yous that they'd like to do as well. I will just say after the speeches, if everyone sort of stay at the tables as well, because the desserts will come straight out. Okay?
Yeah.
So,
enjoy your holiday.
Thank you. Loving can hurt. Loving can hurt sometimes. But it's the only thing that I know. When it gets hard, you know it can get hard sometimes. It is the only thing that makes us feel alive. We keep this love in a photograph. We make these memories for ourselves, where our eyes are never closing, hearts are never broken, and time's forever frozen still. So you can keep me inside the pocket of your ripped jeans, holding me closer till our eyes meet. You won't ever be alone. Wait for me to come home. Loving can heal. Loving can mend your soul. And it's the only thing that I know, know. I swear it will get easier. Remember that with every piece of you. And it's the only thing we take with us when we die. We made these memories for ourselves, where our eyes are never closing, hearts were never broken, time's forever frozen still. So you can keep me inside the pocket of your ripped jeans, holding me closer till our eyes meet.
Mr. Assistant.